Hello students, welcome to our fifth lecture. This is the fifth lecture of our video series. We have covered almost all the arithmetic and logical instructions of assembly language programming. In last lecture we have covered the call instructions and subroutine and how to use the subroutine, right? Now we will be covering a very specific topic using these call instructions, which are known as delay. Actually, in my last lecture also I have shown you how to produce a delay in a program. I'll take an example here also and then tell you how to calculate a specific amount of delay in a program. This is important because some questions would be asked in your semester exam including this topic, from this topic. Fine, so let us start how to produce the delay. So for that we need to understand how the 8051 works, how the 8051 maintains its timing. As I have already taught you in my classes, during my classes, that in a 8051, for example, if you have 8051 like this, in an 8051 there are a number of pins, I mean there are 40 pins. Out of those 40 pins, one is clock. Fine. So what do you provide here? What do you provide at this pin? You provide a clock signal, something like this. I have told you in this class. Fine. So what is this? This is the clock which defines the timing of a process. For example, something is to be done by a microcontroller within this time, or within two clock cycles. How many clock cycles? It depends upon the type of microcontroller. So what does this clock means? This clock means it kind of synchronizes the work between different units of a system. For example, this microcontroller will work, for example, if you have a move instruction, fine, move R0 comma A. So what it is doing, it is moving the data from A to R0. So first it will do what? It will take the data from the register A. Fine, so this is reading the register. Fine, so this it will do in one clock cycle. This is one clock cycle, one time period, one high and one low. So this is one time period. Fine, so it will do this, only this work in one cycle, then moving the data towards the register. Fine, so this is moving the data, it will take one more cycle, and then writing the data into the register, it will take one more cycle. So in total it takes 3 clock cycles. Fine, or 3 clocks. Fine, so this is how the 8051 maintains its schedules its operations. Fine, so let us see it one by one, that how does it works. The number of instruction, the number of clock cycle which an instruction takes is known as machine cycle, known as machine cycle. For example, what I was telling, that move take 3 clock cycles. I have shown you in the last example. This is not exact, I am just assuming that move takes 3 clock cycles. Then in that case, the 3 would be the machine cycle. What is 3? 3 would be the machine cycle, and machine cycle of what? Machine cycle of move instruction. So every instruction has its own machine cycle, or we can say every instruction in 8051 takes certain amount of clock cycles, and those clock cycles are known as machine cycles. Fine. So normally the machine cycle, every machine cycle in 8051 consists of 12 clock periods. What does it mean? It means if you have a clock something like this, if you have a clock something like this, 010101, fine. So 12 such clock cycles, or time periods, you call it time periods, one time period, second time period, third time period. So 12 such time periods or 12 such clocks makes a machine cycle, makes a single machine cycle. Fine, and each instruction takes either a multiple of clock machine cycles. For example, a instruction may take one machine cycle, or another instruction like jump instruction normally takes three machine cycles. Fine. So there are three parts. I'll again repeat, there are three different parts. Fine. One is the clock which you give to the 8051 through the clock pin. Fine. Now grouping 12 such clock cycle make a single machine cycle. So this is a single machine cycle. A set of 12 cycles make a single machine cycle. Fine. Another repeat after this, what will happen? Another 12 clocks will come, and that 12 clocks will be the second machine cycle. Fine. And after this, another 12 clocks will come, that will be third machine cycles. So this is how a machine cycle is made. Fine. And each instruction in 8051 take different number of machine cycle. For example, an instruction like move take one machine cycle, or an instruction like jump takes three machine cycle, or an instruction like call sometimes take four machine cycles. Fine. So you have to remember three things: clock, machine cycle, and how many machine cycle does an instruction takes. Fine. So let us move forward. Let us take an example. We need to calculate that the time period of a machine cycle. Calculate the time period of machine cycle of 8051. Fine. So we need to calculate the time period exactly in seconds. The time period exactly in seconds, that what is the time period of a machine cycle for a 8051. So we know that if it is not given to us, then also we have to assume that the speed at which our 8051 works is 11 megahertz. Fine, you remember this, otherwise it would be given in the questions. If question would be asked from this, then it would be given that the speed or the clock at which this the speed of the clock at which 8051 works is 11 megahertz. Exactly it is 11.0592. Fine. So the question which is given to us is that calculate the time period of the machine cycle. Fine. So we know that the machine cycle consists of 12 clock cycles. Fine. We know that a machine cycle consists of 12 clock cycles. So let us draw it. We have clock cycles of 11 megahertz frequency. So let us say this is the clock of 11 megahertz. 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 01 make one machine cycle. Another 12 makes one more machine cycle, second one. Another 12 makes three machine cycle. So how many machine cycle does we have? How to calculate? Just divide the entire clock cycle by 12. You got it? I'm repeating it. You have the clock cycle of 11 megahertz, something like this. Fine. This is the clock cycle of 11 megahertz. Fine. Now, 12 such clocks make one machine cycle. Another 12 make second machine cycle. Another 12 makes third machine cycle. And then so forth. Fourth, fifth, seventh, sixth machine cycle. Found. How many machine cycle does this clock have? How will I get it? Just divide the entire machine cycle, which is 11 megahertz, divide by 12. You will get the number of machine cycle this clock is having. So what we do? We just divide the 11 megahertz, that is specifically 11.0592 by 12. Fine. So you get the frequency of each machine cycle. Each machine cycle is having a frequency of 921 kilohertz. Fine. By dividing the 11 megahertz with 12, you get 921.6 into 10 power 3. So that is 921.6 kilohertz. Fine. Now, what we wanted? We wanted the period of each machine cycle. What is the period? We have got the frequency, which is 921 kilohertz. Now we want the period, time period. The time period is just the inverse of the frequency. Fine. So just you inverse this value and you'll get the time period of each machine cycle. Fine. So the frequency is 921 kilohertz. To get the time of this time period of this frequency, you just reverse this frequency or get the inverse of the frequency and you get the time period, that is 1.085 microseconds specifically. Please remember this value for other examples. In your exam papers, you have to calculate this value. Fine. So this is what you have got. I'm again repeating so that it should be fitted in your mind perfectly. This is the clock. Fine. Set of such 12 clocks makes one machine cycle. And one machine cycle is of how many seconds? This we have calculated using this example. And this is of 1.085 microsecond. Fine. The length of this machine cycle is 1.085 microsecond. So you can just go through these slides and calculate it again, that how I have calculated the length of single machine cycle. Fine. Now let us go quickly to the example. This is what I wanted to tell you. Look, for example, what this example is asking, that please calculate the amount of time required by 8051 to execute this instruction. What is that instruction? Move R3,55. So what it is doing, it is moving the value 55 into the register R3. How much time does it takes? As a programmer, as a student, you should know that 8051 is working at 11 megahertz of frequency. Then using that frequency, how much time does this instruction takes to execute? Fine. So how to calculate that? For calculating this, you should know that the entire clock cycle is divided into 12 clock cycles, which are known as machine cycle. So this is the frequency of machine cycle, and each machine cycle is of length 1.085 microsecond. You should know this. Fine. And then you calculate the time taken by each instruction. Any instruction you can calculate. How to calculate it? It would be given to you that how many machine cycle does a instruction takes. For example, this instruction move. This instruction takes a machine cycle of 1. Since it takes only one machine cycle, and one machine cycle lasts for how much time? It lasts for 1.085 second. So total time that would be taken by this instruction would be 1.085 microsecond only. So how to calculate? How to calculate the time taken by each instruction? You just simply multiply 1.085 by the number of cycles, by the number of machine cycles which it takes. That is very simple. You just need to know the number of machine cycle which an instruction takes, and then multiply that number of machine cycle with the length of the machine cycle, so that you can get the total time taken by an instruction. So let us take one more example. This E, that is short jump. The short jump takes 2 machine cycle. Since short jump takes 2 machine cycle, and each machine cycle is of length 1.085, so 2 machine cycle will take 2 multiplied by 1.085. So total 2.17 microsecond. It's very easy. So the total time taken by short jump is 2.17 microsecond. See, multiply AB. MULAB. We have already discussed this instruction. Fine. So MULAB, what it is doing, it is multiplying the content of register A and B and giving the results inside A and B again. Fine. So how much machine cycle does it takes? It takes 4 machine cycles, and each machine cycle is of length 1.085. So total 4 machine cycle will take 4 multiplied by 1.085, that is 4.34 microseconds. So it's very easy. Fine. Let us move forward. And this is the motive of our lecture today, to calculate the delay. For that purpose, we have taken a program. What this program is doing, I'll quickly explain to you. It is moving 55 to the accumulator. See, we are again and again using the same examples, 55 and AA. We will take the value 55, make its complement. What is the complement of 55? 55 is 0101 and 0101. The complement of 55 would be 1010, 1010. That is nothing but AA. Fine. So we'll take again and again same example. Why we are using this example, I'll just tell you in a second. First, we'll look at this program. This is moving 55 into the accumulator, then moving the value of the accumulator into the port P1. Fine. What is this port P1? P1 is the port. Actually, you have the 8051, something like this. Then you have port 8 bit port 0, then 8 bit port 1, and 8 bit port 2, and 8 bit port. Yeah, just we have two, three ports. So port 0, port 1, port 2. I'm talking about this port. Fine. So from inside the microcontroller, you can take the value outside also, or from outside, you can take the value inside the microcontroller through these ports. Through these three ports, fine. So we are using these ports here. Fine, we are using these ports here. So what we are doing, we are moving the value 55 into the accumulator, and then moving that value, because 55 is in the accumulator, so moving that value inside to the port P1. Then I am calling a delay, then I am calling a subroutine. The name is delay. So where the program will move after this instruction, the program will start executing from here, because this is delay. It will ignore this instruction, and what will happen, the address of this instruction would be saved to, it will be saved to the stack pointer, right? It will be moved to it will be moved to stack. Fine. I've taught you in this in these things in the last class. Fine. So it will call the delay subroutine. What will delay subroutine do? It has taken value 200 into the register R3, and by using the instruction DJNZ, decrement and jump if non-zero, it will keep on decrementing the value of R3 from 200 to 199, then to 198, till 150, then 100, then 99, till 0. Once it becomes 0, it will go to the next instruction, which is return. Return means you go to the your main program. And what is your main program? This is your main program. So it will execute from here. That is complement A. When you complement the 55, it will become AA. Then short jump again. So it will again go to the same location. This time you are moving A to P1. And what is A? A accumulator is containing this time AA, because you have change its value. So what is happening here, what this program is doing, I'll again tell you. The port 8 bit port P1 of the 8051, from the 8 bit port P1, the values which you are getting from this port P1 are 55, and after some time, after this much delay AA, and after again the same delay, it will be 55. Then after the some delay, it would be AA. Then after some delay, it would be 55. So continuously, the value from the port P1 which you are getting would be 55, AA, 55, AA, 55. Fine. This is what this program is doing. Fine. You should understand this, because this program is very important. I think you should go through this program once again. If you have any doubt, you should go through this program once again, and you'll get to know that how this program is working. Fine. So if you want, I'll again explain it to you within I'll take just one more minute and explain, because some students might be confused in this. It is moving the value 55 to the accumulator. Fine. Now the accumulator contains 55. Fine. So the data of the accumulator goes to the port P1. What is going to the port P1? This value 55. Fine. Now you're calling the subroutine delay. What is this subroutine delay is? The subroutine delay is a register R3 contains 200. Now you keep on decrementing the value of R3 until it becomes 0. DJNZ, we have already studied in last class. What does it mean? It means decrement and jump when the value is non-zero. Fine. So when the value is non-zero, it will jump to here. And where is here? Here is this. So it will keep on jumping here until the R3 becomes 0. When the R3 becomes 0, it will go to the next line. What is the next line? That is return. Return means go to your main program, return to your main program. And what is your main program? Your main program is here. You have left here. So it will start from here. It will complement the value of A. Complement means convert 55 into its complement. What is the complement of 55? I have already told you in last class. The complement of 55 is AA. So now the accumulator contains AA. The accumulator now contains AA. Fine. So what is AA? It's a hexadecimal value. Fine. Now short jump again. It will go to again. Now the value of the accumulator will go to the P1. What does accumulator now contain? It contains AA. Again, it will be complemented after some delay. So AA will become 55. Like this, the port P1, the value which comes out from the port P1. You have the port P1 something like this. The value which comes out through this is 55, then some delay, then AA, then some delay, then again 55, then some delay. So this is how it is working. Fine. I think now this program is very clear to everyone, each student, that how it this is giving the data 55 and then AA, then 55 from the port P1. Now this is simple, but the main thing is this, that if you are having the speed of the microcontroller, that is 11 megahertz, then you are getting the output from port P1, that is 55, and then a delay, and then AA. So what is the time duration of this delay? As a programmer, you should know that how much delay you have produced between two values, AA and 55. It depends, this delay depends upon what? This delay depends upon the value or the time taken by this subroutine. Fine. This delay is because of this subroutine which we are calling this subroutine. Fine. So the total time taken by this subroutine will be the delay between these two values. Fine. So now here we will calculate the total time taken by this subroutine, because we know how to calculate the time taken by an instruction. We have already done this in this slide, right? Like this instruction was taking this much time, this instruction was taking this much time. We know that how much time will be taken by an instruction. So this subroutine is nothing but a set of instruction. So we will calculate that how much time would be taken by this instruction, how much time would be taken by this, how much time would be taken by this. Then we will add all these times and we will get to know that how much time is taken by all these instructions. So we will get to know that how much is the delay which is produced by using this subroutine. Fine. Before doing that, we should know the machine cycle taken by each instruction. Fine. In the last example also, the machine cycle was given. See, the machine cycle of each instruction was given. Here also, before calculating, the machine cycle was given to you, that move takes one machine cycle. Always it will take one machine cycle independent of the value which you are giving in the move. It will take one machine cycle. Fine. And DJNZ, any jumping instruction will take two machine cycle. You need not to remember, it will be given to you. Fine. And the return will again take two machine cycles. Fine. So how to calculate the time? See, this instruction is executed only for one time. It will not be executed again. Fine. So one machine cycle for move instruction. Now this instruction will also be executed for single time. So two machine cycle for return. But this instruction will be executed for how much time? Please tell me. Please pause this video and answer my question, that this instruction will be executed for how many times? Definitely R3 contains the value 200. So until 200 becomes 0, it will be executed. It will be executed like this. So this instruction will be executed 200 times. Fine. And since this instruction is taking two machine cycle, so the total machine cycle which is taken by this repeating instruction is 2 multiplied by 200. Fine. So this is what written here, that the 2 multiplied by 200 is the total machine cycle taken by second instruction. One machine cycle was taken by first instruction and two machine cycle was taken by third instruction. Now total machine cycle, when we multiplied by the length of each machine cycle, we have calculated this in our lecture. This is the total time of a single machine cycle. Fine. So total machine cycle multiplied by the length will give the total time taken by all these three instructions. Fine. And that comes out to be 436 microsecond approximately. So the total delay which is produced here is of what time? Is of 436 microsecond. Now you all students are in a condition to tell that how much time would be taken by a program for executing with 8051. Fine. So in the questions it can be given to you, a program would be given to you, and you need to calculate that how much time will be taken by 8051 to execute that program. Fine. This is one more example. I'll leave this example to you. This is a very simple same example. Different instructions are given to you, and you need to calculate that how much time is taken by these instructions altogether. Fine. Solution is in front of you, so you just verify it. Just verify this. So I'll leave this to you. Fine. You just verify it, that how the total time will be calculated here. Fine. Let us move forward. This is one more example. You do this example also. Please practice this example as well as this example. Fine. Now we'll move to a new section. So we'll close this video here itself, and please practice these programs, because some of the questions will definitely be asked from this section. So thanks as of now, and if there's any doubt, I'm enabling the comment section in the YouTube videos, so you can comment also, or you can write on the WhatsApp group itself, so that the doubts would be cleared hand to hand. Fine. Thanks.